The earthquake and tsunami of 2 weeks ago left Japan suffering and in desperate need of economic recovery. These disasters could just be the beginning of Japan's problems. Irina Yamamoto joins us now to tell us about Japan's struggling economy.
It's been 2 weeks since the wave of death hit northern Japan. The aftermath of the 9.0 magnitude earthquake and tsunami is now affecting the Japanese economy as well.
The Japanese economy is extremely unstable right now. On March 17th, the yen marked at 77 yen for $1 on the exchange market. This figure is recorded as the highest in Japan's post-war history. A SF State economics professor is anticipating the Japanese economy like this.
Well, certainly in the short run, they will have a decrease in their output. I would suspect, will have something of a recession out of this. They've had several recessions in the last 10 years when you look at the behavior of the Japanese economy.
She also says the nuclear problems are keeping Japan from the quick economic recovery.
The Japanese people will probably rethink their use of nuclear power. One of the things that characterizes Japan is that they really don't have natural resources to power things. So it'll be interesting to see how that works out.
According to Mainichi newspapers, especially Japanese automobile companies are worried about how their exports will be affected because Japan highly depends on them. Other business owners are also trying hard to prevent serious depressions. They believe the economic recovery is encouraging the rehabilitation of the devastated areas.
An IFM spokesperson says Japan has not requested financial assistance from the international community. Japan currently has the resources to handle this crisis and says it will eventually recover as it has done after previous disasters. Live in newsroom, I'm Erin Yamamoto. Back to you, studio.